So under topics 1, we learn about types of data. This one should come out in the exam. Any questions so far? Okay, now exercise 2.2. Nah, ini mesti tak buat lah ni. Okay, page 22. Kalau tak buat, kena buat sekarang. Eh? Anyway, let's go through one by one. You have done, please check your answers. Exercise 2.2, we are given a table. The question asks us to give the number of students that acquired not more than 29 marks. Kalau tak lebih dari 29 markah, what we do is we must have a cumulative frequency table. Yeah, understand? Not? So, before we can answer this question, we have to do this table. Ini table baru lah. Just now the question give one simple table ni, frequency table. So what we do is, tukar jadi bentuk macam ni. You must have the marks, then you must have the number of students di sini. Itu yang dibagi. Then we create the third column called cumulative frequency. So how to get cumulative frequency? Sini 10, tulis 10 dulu. You can use arrow lah. 10, arrow, 10. Lepas tu 10, turun bawah, campur dengan 25, you get what? 35. Faham tu? Then 35 tambah 35, 70. 70, 20, 90. 90, 10, 100. Okay? Alright, so I've done this for you already. Now, answer the question now. Question A, what's the answer?
25.
Question say less than 29. So less than 29, 35 is only less lah. So accumulated number is 35. Dengar tak? Maksudnya 35 equals 4 marks between 10 to 29 lah. Or less than 29. Faham tu? Okay, question B. Give the number of students that acquire 30 or more marks.
65.
30 or more mana? Sini sampai sini kan?
Yes.
Jadi saya tunjuk bukan tengok ni. You have to take the less first, then you take the total minus this. You get 65. Faham semua? So your answer will be this one. 100 minus 35. Okay. Just now I see the arrow lah di sana, nampak tak? Nah, arrow banyak-banyak ni. Okay, ya? Okay, let's go to question 2 now. Huh? Question 2 ni refer to the frequency table given in question 1. Ingat? That means rujuk balik question 1. I have copy again sini lagi sekali. Just now, but this time if you look at the question, it says A obtain the class midpoint. Kena cari midpoint for all the classes. Kalau all no choice lah, kena salin balik all the jadual. Then all the class midpoint. Tapi in the exam I told you mid semester objective they will not ask this type of question. They will ask one class ni. Yang senang ni jawab that class ni. Alright, but anyway for practice purpose we do all lah. So all classes midpoint. How do we get this midpoint? So for answer A, you take 10 plus 19 divide by 2. Is it correct? 14.5.
Yes.
Then the rest pun ikut je lah. Kalau dia punya class width all same, if the first one 14.5, next one 34.5, the next one 34.5, just salin je. But before you do that, check nicely. Semua sama lah. Kalau semua sama, tak payah buat banyak-banyak kali. Just do one enough. Understand? Okay, second question. Obtain the table of relative frequency. So, relative frequency, where is it? This one lah. Yang merah ni nampak. Relative frequency, usually we refer to percentage.